Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. It's been a while, it's half a year, and I really needed the time off to recover. And I did well because I resumed producing music. You can check that out on Riftam. It was a very enjoyable experience for me. I really needed the time off to do that. So here I am again in a bit of a different setting. You won't see the studio as you're used to. This is a simplified setup and it allows me to do a video production faster. All right, first let's have a look at the seismic events, the major seismic events that we had in the last several months, and then I will address the upcoming geometry, most notably the Sun-Saturn-Neptune conjunction, the great grand conjunction that happens once every 36 years or so. So let's have a look what happened since July. A 7.3 in the Alaska Peninsula on the 16th of July, followed by a 7.4, 4 days later only, off the east coast of Kamchatka. It's quite a seismic increase because normally a magnitude 7 earthquakes happens every 20, 24 days on average, and that's theory. In reality, we see two big quakes in 4 days, and that's not all, because this 7.4 happened to be a foreshock of a much larger earthquake, magnitude 8.8, on July 29th. So what was the geometry that in the planetary and lunar geometry that caused this seismic increase? Here we see the twin magnitude 7 earthquakes. This is not the first time. I think 2017 or so, we also had two magnitude 7 earthquakes back to back in the North Pacific, one in Alaska and one in Kamchatka. So it isn't the first time. We look at the planetary and lunar geometry. Most notably, we see the green lines here in the solar system. Earth more or less between Mars on one side and Saturn and Neptune on the other side. And that allows for very critical lunar geometry, as we had on the 28th, 29th of July, just before the megathrust earthquake, magnitude 8.8. And this is because these conjunctions are in an opposite fashion. Mars on one side, and then Saturn and Neptune on the other side. And then we have a convergence of zero angle conjunctions with the Moon in a very short time, 24 hours or so. And that's what you see happening here. And in addition, we had planetary conjunctions also, Venus-Sun-Mars on the 25th, and Mercury-Venus-Uranus also on the 29th, converging with the critical lunar geometry, and then only hours later we had this massive earthquake off the coast of Kamchatka. Here on this SHI graph, we see the 7.3 in Alaska, because that's where that planetary geometry actually became effective. As you can see, Moon-Earth-Mars on the that was on the 15th, and then Earth-Moon-Saturn and Earth-Moon-Neptune in conjunctions, also high lunar peaks just before the 7.3 earthquake. And the same thing happened with the 8.8 in Kamchatka. High lunar peak, clustering of conjunctions, lunar conjunctions, and we had a big earthquake. And also Earth was closely aligned with Saturn and Neptune. That's the red line, horizontal line, for many days. And the blue line below, that's the Earth. So Earth was really there in a critical position in the solar system. Here we see the magnitude 8.8 off the coast of the east coast of Kamchatka. The last time that such a megathrust earthquake occurred in the area was in 1952, and that was November, magnitude 9.0. And these are really big earthquakes. And here we see the magnitude 8.8 on the SHI graph. Like I said, a high lunar peak just as with the Alaska earthquake on the 16th. Earth, Moon, Mars, Moon, Earth, Saturn, and Moon, Earth, Neptune. A clustering of lunar conjunctions in a very short time with outer planets in an opposite fashion. That is really critical. If you want to study this phenomenon with megathrust earthquakes and this kind of planetary geometry, I suggest you study the year 1906, when Uranus and Neptune, the outermost planets, were on opposite sides of the solar system. And to date, 1906 is still seismically the most active year on record, with several magnitude 8 earthquakes, including 8.8 in Ecuador in January 1906, and also, of course, the great San Francisco earthquake. Okay, I almost forgot about a tweet that I posted in June 2022, because at that time I studied the Uranus cycles. And the data set that I used to do this study covered seven centuries, more than 700 years. And I noticed that Uranus is at very specific positions in the solar system when we have very large earthquakes like this 8.8. And at that time, I estimated 3 years ago that from 2023 to 2025, there is would be a higher probability of an 8.5 or larger earthquake, with the highest probability in 2024-2025. And it turned out to be correct. So this is very interesting, because if you use a data set and you do a study and you see a pattern emerging from that data set, and then you do an estimate based on that data set, then, and it actually comes true, that is basically a confirmation that there is something to that position of Uranus, to the role of Uranus in the solar system, should not be underestimated. All right. Then in August, or August 22nd, the same geometry continued with Mars on one side, Saturn, Neptune on the other side, and there on August 22nd, a 7.5 magnitude earthquake in the Drake Passage, south of Chile, South America. It was not the only major earthquake there, because in October we had another one there, magnitude 7.6. Quite some activity there in the South Sea. And as you can see with the 7.5, again, I labeled them in green, the lunar geometry in the days preceding that major earthquake. And again, we see Mars, Saturn and Neptune in a role, also Jupiter in there. You can pause the video and study these SGI graphs and the planetary and lunar geometry involved. It's very interesting. And then in September, 13 September, the first aftershock, major aftershock, near the east coast of Kamchatka, 7.4. And there was another one, 7.8. And if we look at the planetary lunar geometry preceding that aftershock, we see again Mars, Neptune, Saturn, with lunar geometry involved there, high lunar geometry, and also semi-right angle geometry, Jupiter and Mars, 4,535 degrees on the 12th, 13th. Very interesting that even these major aftershocks also occur in sync with specific planetary lunar geometry in the solar system. Okay, here's the 7.8, the largest aftershock, and that occurred on September 18th. All right, then on October 10th, we had two magnitude 7 earthquakes. That is very unusual, even more unusual than what we had in July. Like I said, on average, a magnitude 7 earthquake occurs every 20, 24 days. And now we had two on one day. So it's always interesting when it happens to look at the positions of the planets and the moon in the solar system. Here's the 7.6 again in the Drake Passage, like I said. And now we have we look at the geometry from 8 to 11 October. And what we see is very interesting. Earth again between planets, Venus on one side, Saturn on the other side. The moon made critical geometry, like semi-right angle geometry with Venus and Saturn, and a conjunction with Mars at the same time. This is a tight convergence of lunar geometry, and that should never be underestimated. Normally, I would say mid to high 6, usually around high 6 magnitude, borderline 7. This is quite a large 2 magnitude 7 earthquakes as a result of this particular planetary and lunar geometry. Always look at the positions of the planets and the moon. The Earth is very much part of the solar system, as you can see. And here on the SGI graph, we see both magnitude 7 earthquakes, and I labeled the lunar geometry at the top. Saturn-Neptune conjunctions on the 6th, and then here we have Moon-Earth-Mars on the 9th, and Earth-Moon-Uranus as well, and also Venus-Saturn, like I said, semi-right angle geometry, and Neptune also, and that converges here on the 8th, 9th, with that lunar conjunction Moon-Earth-Mars. So when we have a convergence of geometry, that is what causes significant seismic increase. And now we go to look at the geometry that is coming up. Like I said, we're going to have a grand conjunction Sun, Saturn, Neptune. That will be exact on 11 December. The last time that this particular alignment occurred, Sun, Saturn, Neptune in the conjunction, in the same fashion, was in July 1989. And so it is quite rare. It doesn't happen very often. And every time when that happens, the positions of the planets are very different, and also the position of the Moon relative to the planets. This time, it's very interesting, we're going to have quite a bunch of planetary conjunctions converging from 8 to 12 December. It starts with Venus, Sun, Uranus on the 8th, and that will be followed by Mars, Mercury, Jupiter on the 9th, Mercury, Earth, Uranus on the 10th, Sun, Saturn, Neptune on the 11th, and then we have two lunar conjunctions, Moon, Earth, Saturn, Moon, Earth, Neptune, very significant. I'll come to that in a minute when I show you the SGI graph. And then Mercury, Saturn, Neptune on the 12th, Mercury, Sun, Neptune on the 12th, and then Mercury, Sun, Saturn on the 12th. So this is a real tight convergence of planetary conjunctions, seven in total, and then we really need to look at the lunar geometry when that happens. Here is an image of additional lunar geometry, apart from the conjunctions that I just showed you. We have 135 degrees in wide angles. We have Mars on one side and Saturn and Neptune on the other side. And that is also a critical factor. It comes on top. It happens on the 8th of December. And if we look at the SGI graph, we see quite a lot is going to happen here. It starts tomorrow, late tomorrow, with Moon, Earth, Sun. That is a full moon. And we see a convergence of lunar conjunctions, first with Moon, Earth, Venus, then the full moon, and then we have Moon, Earth, Mars. And that can result in some stronger seismic activity, the typical 5.5 plus earthquakes in temporal clustering. That is very important, that we have this temporal clustering. That is a very well-known phenomenon in seismology, but not really well addressed, to be honest, or explained. Then we have Earth, Moon, Jupiter on the 7th, critical lunar conjunction, and then Venus, Sun, Uranus, like I said, on the 8th. There's the first critical planetary conjunction, and we see that that will be followed by, again, Mars, Saturn, Neptune, those three planets, but now it's in semi-right angle geometry, wide angle 135 degrees. And I suspect that there can be quite a seismic increase there as a result, mid to high 6 magnitude, because of the wide angle lunar geometry. It could also reach magnitude 7. Mars, Mercury, Jupiter on the 9th. I already told you these planetary conjunctions. It's really concentrated here from the 8th to the 12th. And then we have to look at the lunar conjunctions at the end, that is with Saturn and with Neptune, because that is usually the indicator of potential large seismic activity following that lunar peak. So that would be on the 13th or 14th, around the 14th, give or take one day. That could be critical. There could be significant seismic activity coming up as a result of the convergence of planetary geometries from the 8th to the 12th, followed by that high lunar peak there. And this is the geometry that we are going to have in December. Again, a very rare grand conjunction, Sun, Saturn, Neptune, but we see that there is quite some geometry around it, planetary and lunar geometry. So it is it's very interesting, but also be on extra alert for potential larger seismic activity. This is the update. Stay safe. Until next time.